Howdy, toddy, everybody. This is Tommy with Colonel Reb Scale Models coming at you with a video. My first video in several months since I think I finished the Stuka. It's been busy, gone back to work, starting last week, getting the school ready for, we're doing universal remote learning or virtual learning. Not too happy about that, but it is what it is. So just trying to get things ready. Everybody's has to, all the teachers, and we all have to be at school and do our remote teaching from the school itself, you know, using masks and all that. And we're all separated. We don't go into each other's classrooms. We meet, have our meetings with each other online. So it's kind of strange, but I've been doing a lot with devices, giving our kids, our third through fifth graders are all going to have devices. So we're distributing those tomorrow. So I've been working on getting those ready for the past week and a half. And then I got a buttload of trainings after that, virtual trainings to do online. So it's going to be interesting when the kids get back to school starting on Monday. So making this video, kind of piggybacking on Papa Dan's video that he just did earlier this week, talking about our Ming Tiger Models group build that we're hosting in the month, starting in September. It'll run for the month, but it has no end date. So just build as you can. And, you know, it's fun. We just wanted to showcase these models because we've done some ourselves. He's got most of them. I've got a good handful. But, you know, if you've done egg planes, they're very similar to that, except they're snap tight. They're kind of like Bandai type quality as far as putting things together and staying together. I've only had to put a drop of glue here or there just to get a seam closer and tighter than what it would normally be. But that's up to you. The kits are, you know, Tiger Models as the cute planes like you see here. Papa Dan has shown a lot of them because he has most of the collection. And then you have the Ming airplanes and tanks. Both of these you can get at Hobby Lobby, and there's two other tanks, I think a Sherman and another German tank that you can get at Hobby Lobby. I think they're still like $12.99 plus, you know, minus the 40% coupon if you use that, and this one would be the same. The one up here is a newer release. They just came out not long ago, so Dan got one, I got one, and actually Brian over at BG's Models, he got one. So we are going to do a buddy build using those. I'm building this one. This one's for my sister. She's a big Titanic freak. And so she wants this one to just sit at her, what used to be office. I guess she's working from home now, but she wants to be able to have it sitting on her desk. So I'm just gonna, I think I have to paint a little bit on the deck, just that color, and the rest of it will probably just be from the box. Not too many parts. There's a very low part count kits, but they're pretty cool. I like them. The one I did that I showed you guys that was the Warhawk turned out really nice, I thought. And then, like I said, we just want to expose everybody to have the chance to get exposure by buying these kits and then building them because they are fun. Yeah, thanks to Charlie Mack for doing like a little mention of it in one of his latest videos, because we want to challenge all those that have participated the last couple of years in the Eggplane group build, which is also very fun, that they host every year in the spring, to, you know, try to get one of these kits and see what you think. Like I said, there's you know, pros and cons of each one of them, and we're not trying to say that one is better than the other, but it's just an alternative. So want everybody to join, and I'm going to put a couple of links to some videos as kind of like a shout out, but also to showcase kind of what can be done with these kits. One is I think it was a B-24, this one actually, that Alex Modeling, our friend over in Portugal, who does amazing work with planes and with ships and stuff. I think he did this one. I can't remember now, but he did one. So I'll put the link to his video, and then also to Freddie over at Sooner Models. He did a tank. He did one, I can't remember if it was this one. He did a tank, and I mean, he pretty much went all out. I mean, it's not like you would do a real armor tank where you do some PE and things like that, but he did it well with the weathering and stuff. I mean, it looks amazing. So I'll put a link to that so you can see what that can look like. And then also Bernie over at Godfather Customs, when we did the Coral Sea group bill back, what, two springs ago, he did an amazing little diorama with the Lexi, which is one of these kits that you could get from Hobby Lobby. Sometimes you can still see maybe some on clearance. I picked up like five of them off clearance one day because they were marked down to like $2 or something. But just to have, just because I thought, I mean, I can't pass that up. So I haven't finished mine. I finished the ship part. I haven't done the planes. One of those group builds I still haven't finished that I intend to do. But the ship is actually built. I just wanted to go and do a little bit more detail, and not to the extent that Bernie did with the diorama in the ocean and the planes taking off and stuff. But something decent, but definitely not to that skill level. So I'll put links to those three builders and their videos of their builds, just to kind of show what can be done. And then I wanted to issue personal challenges to my buddy over there, Martin, International British Modeler, who does amazing work with planes, to see if he would jump in and build one of these things. And then also my buddy out in Alberta, Glockster 42 from Scale Model Alberta, who does a lot of tanks. So he would definitely be able to do one of these and just really do it full blown. And he probably has time on his hands since now the Oilers have gotten eliminated from the NHL playoffs. So he's got a little bit extra time to work on those. But, we already have a lot of people committed, because we've been talking about this for several months. So we have Evan, who does, amazing, amazing armor work. Panzermeister 36 is his channel name. He's got, I remember watching him when he was just kind of starting out. And, I mean, the amount of progress that he's made as a builder is just amazing, and the amount of followers that he has. We have also Chris over at CP101. He's going to jump in and do something. Not sure which one, which type. Panzerman Bill said he was looking forward to maybe jumping in. And then also Tom, old Rambler 69, is going to surprise us with something, some type of one of these kits. So, like I said, we're just kind of opening up to everybody. All those egg plane builders, those Hasegawa kits, if you want to try one of these, you can kind of compare and contrast. They are no glue, and they fit together really well, just like most Bandai kits do. And then it's just a matter of your imagination, how much you want to put into the painting, the weathering, the detailing. And they can look like really cool little models, just something different. They're almost like with Bandai, they have Gundams, if you built in the Gundams, and I like to build these, the super, what they call super deformed, or the SD kits. That's kind of what these are. It's kind of that cartoonish super deformed kind of look. But you can see what it is, you can tell what it is by looking at it. It's out of scale, it's out of proportion. It kind of makes them cute, as far as like at least for the planes go. But for the most part, they have like rubber tracks on some of the tanks, and the propellers are spinning, things like that. What I'm going to build, I got to build this, and I have to have it built, start on it soon, because I got to take it with me back to Mississippi when I go to my niece's wedding, middle of September. I'm going to take it to her then, so I got to get working on that. But what I'm going to do also is this one. This is the Sherman. This is the Sherman kit that they have that you can buy the normal version of, and this is the Santa Claus one, the Christmas edition. So I want to do that. I just thought that was just too cool to pass up, to have a little Santa Claus and a little red Sherman tank. That would be a cool little diorama to do, I thought. Try my hand again to do a little bit better job on the snow than I did on the Stukas base. But I also have the T 72, no, the T-34, I'm sorry, the T-34-76, which I started working on it a few months ago. I have painted it to match the colors, and I started doing a little bit of weathering, and that's about when I stopped. So I may try to finish that one at some point too. So that's another one that you can go online and get. But there's probably 20 to 30 different planes, ships, tanks, that you can buy through either one of these vendors, either one of these kit producers, and jump on in. So again, I hope everybody's doing well out there with all this craziness going on, the pandemic and everything. Kids about to start going back to school. Hopefully we'll have some college football. Otherwise I'm gonna be very depressed, but we'll have a lot of time to build if we don't have college football. Anyway, so as always, hotty toddy and God bless.